यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारतः अभ्युत्थान अधर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधूनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे.
Meaning, whenever there is decay of righteousness, O Bharat, and there is exaltation of unrighteousness, then I myself come forth for the protection of the good, for the destruction of the evildoers, for the sake of firmly establishing righteousness. I am born from age to age. I, Payal Ahir,
and I, Avish Kaushik,
are privileged to be the comparers of the river. Well, we won't tell you from which river we belong
madam,
to.
Madam. Hey, bhaiya, why are you talking, man? Are you a commerce student?
No, I'm not a commerce student.
You prepared this by looking at the videos from last year, na? Are you a commerce student? Okay, let's go park it and we'll start with the first scene.
And today was the day one who was going to end the reign of the evil king Kans was going to take birth. Kans was waiting to kill his killer. The guards were guiding the gates of prison. Devaki and Vasudev were praying to Lord Vishnu to keep their infant safe.
After some time, the divine child was born. At that time, in all directions, there was an atmosphere of peace and prosperity. Vasudev and Devaki found themselves magically freed from the prison chains. All the prison guards fell asleep and the gates were open.
In order to keep the child safe, Vasudev decided to take the child to his dear friend Nand's place. Passing through all the hurdles, Vasudev reached Nand's place. Vasudev kept the divine child with him and took Nand's girl child with him.
The boy was named Krishna. Krishna grew up in an environment full of love and glory. He enjoyed eating makhan mishri with his friends. In his entire childhood, Krishna performed many leelas like lifting the Govardhan Parvat, stealing makhan from the gopis, troubling the gopis, and of course, killing a dozen of demons.
With the arrival of the autumn season, the water in the lakes and rivers became as crystal and the water filled with fragrant lotus flowers. Krishna was playing flute and all the gopis were enjoying the vibration of Krishna's flute.
Gopis' love for Krishna, especially Radha, her love was not as a physical passion. It was the supreme love. When they thought of Lord Krishna, everyone forgot their worldly activities. They were merged in the love of Krishna.
The time had come to end Kans. After killing the wrestlers of Kans in front of the whole kingdom, Krishna killed Kans in the entire kingdom of Kans.
He immediately knocked down the crown from the head of Kans. He then dragged Kans from the seat to the wrestling arena and threw him over, thus killing him. Later, he was crowned as the king of Dwarka. Dhritarashtra, Bhishma, Pandavas, Vidur, Kauravas, Dronacharya, Karna, Shakuni, Ashwathama, and all the dignitaries from the Kuru Vansh were present there. They were witnessing the coronation of Yudhishthira as the prince of the mighty kingdom of Hastinapur. As we can see, Yudhishthira was crowned as the prince of Hastinapur, which further led to conflicts, which will lead to the great war of Mahabharata.
And thus began the era of the great story Mahabharata. While Krishna was ruling Dwarka, Sudama, his childhood friend, decided to meet him.
The poor Brahmin Sudama decided to visit Krishna. He decided to visit the Dwarkadhish, the king of Dwarka. And Krishna, And Krishna respected his friendship by washing his feet with his tears. Tears of joy meeting his old friend. Draupadi was the daughter of the king Draupad. She was touted to be the most beautiful woman of that era. When she attained youth, Draupad wanted her wedding to happen. Thus, Draupadi Swayamvar was organized with great fanfare. Many dignitaries, including Lord Krishna, Karna, Shakuni, Dushasan, and all the dignitaries of the Kuru clan were present there.
Pandavas were also present there. Pandavas were supposed to be killed in the house of Lakshagriha, but they were present there in the disguise of Brahmins. The challenge was to pierce the eye of a revolving fish by looking at its reflection in a pan of oil. Whosoever can bend the bow and pierce the eye of the fish may marry Draupadi. Many kings tried to target the fish, but no one could do it. Just when it looked like nobody could do it, Arjun came forward and he targeted the fish.
The darkest day of Hastinapur had arrived. Well, I guess you guys know what's coming. It's the gamble, it's the game which would decide the future of the ancient India. The game of Chaucer, where Yudhishthir decided to play the game and he bet all his brothers, his wife, all his wealth, and even his own wisdom. As we can see, Bhim, hanging his head in shame after the defeat, Kauravas teasing them, the four Pandavas trying to announce the war. Bhim, he decided to take an oath. Bhim decided that he will rip apart the hands of Dushasan and break the thigh of Duryodhana.
Pandavas were not ashamed, but they took this as a challenge.
And hence we have a management lesson. If you have a problem, make it an opportunity. They decided to go to Vanvas and learn new things so that they would fight the war and bring peace back in our country.
After spending 30 years in exile, the scene is set for the war. Arjun is trembling right before the war. Why should I fight my own kith and kins? Why should I fight the war? Why? Then, Krishna gives Arjun a very important lesson. Pay attention to your work. Don't worry about your results. As you sow, so shall you reap.
These teachings were a part of the holy book Gita. Krishna then addresses Bhishma Pitama, the oldest person in the Kurukshetra battlefield. He gave him a very important life lesson, that whatever decision you make, it might be applicable at that particular time, but it won't matter now. Suppose if you make a tradition back then, 100 years ago, it won't be applicable today.
Addressing Dronacharya, Krishna gave the message that confidence is good, but overconfidence always sinks the ship. His love for his son Ashwatthama blinded him, and he was forced to fight for the evil side.
Now here comes the end of the Mahabharata war. Bhim decided to finish it once for all. It was the Gada Yudh between Bhim and Duryodhan.
And we were from the river Krishna.